Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Stormy Adventure Time, and my name is Storm. And today I would like to share with you a couple of my favorite Instagrammable places around London. So without further ado, let's just jump straight into those places. So the first location is Kew Gardens. I just loved this beautiful botanical garden because it's Instagrammable all year round. You can always find something absolutely beautiful. There are lovely places which are not always noticeable at the first sight, and there are lovely angles you can use. There are, in spring, it's just a heaven for Instagram because there are flowers blooming all over the place. And I actually did recently a video about cherry blossoms in London, and part of it was filmed in Kew Gardens, which was absolutely gorgeous and obviously less busy than other places. Also, it's perfect all year round because there are lovely greenhouses, so you can have beautiful pictures on lovely white spiral staircases, a video about, and it's just beautiful. I love it. There's always something to take pictures of. So if you ever visited my Instagram account, which you should, and I will leave it on the screen so you can check it out, you'll see that I visited quite frequently. So the next place is Hampstead. I would not say the whole Hampstead because I don't really know it that well. I visited the first time less than a year ago, and I haven't explored that much, but I'm sure you can find plenty of places. But my go-to place is Hampstead East with its beautiful hill gardens and pergola. It just absolutely stunning. It's just beautiful. I've seen many pictures before I went, and it actually exceeded my expectations when I saw it in real life, so it is definitely worth a visit, as you can see even some clips which I'm adding on the screen. Next location is in central London, and that is Covent Garden. Covent Garden is such a lovely area, and obviously Market itself is very Instagrammable, but what is really lovely about Covent Garden Market is that they actually have beautiful Instagrammable spots ready for you. They are seasonal, they update them every couple of months, so you would always have beautiful floral swings. They're always decorated for special occasions, like around Halloween there was a massive pumpkin patch, around Christmas they have beautiful displays. There's always something to take pictures of. My next location, which I love, is Greenwich, and you probably know that love already because I showed it quite a few times already in my videos, and one of them was recent, about cherry blossoms, the same as Kew Gardens. If you haven't seen it, I will leave it linked on the screen so you can check it out. In Greenwich you can get an amazing view of the city, and you can take a lovely, I would say classic already, image with the Maritime Museum and the cityscape behind it. It's so beautiful, especially if you manage to get here really early and there's a fog. It looks magical. Also, there's a beautiful alley in the park where you have cherry blossoms, where you have cherries blooming on both sides, and it looks absolutely beautiful. And cherries are blooming. It's just a little bit crowded if you come on the weekend, so it's either very early in the morning if you want to enjoy it in the less crowded environment, or more towards the weekdays. And love and Greenwich itself is such a beautiful area, so just wander around, and especially if you go on early morning, you can see lovely empty little side streets, and they look simply magical in the morning when there is no one around. So the last area in London which I would like to mention is Notting Hill, and obviously when you think about Notting Hill, first thing for me that pops in the mind is those beautiful colorful houses next to each other on the street, and that is so lovely. There are some specific streets, but to be honest, if you just walk a little bit around, explore Notting Hill more, I'm sure you'll find quite a few of them, because there are a few streets like this. Notting Hill in general is such a lovely area where you just wander around and you will see plenty of spaces. Now in general around London, I would say just wander around, don't be afraid to explore, especially areas like Chelsea, Mayfair, Fitzrovia. They are absolutely gorgeous and just keep wondering because I just find beautiful spots just passing by areas without even specifically looking for Instagrammable spots. One thing I would like to remember that whenever you find a beautiful house which you want to have a picture for your Instagram account, please remember that someone might be living in the house and it is very likely that someone is living in the house. So please respect people's privacy and just be mindful when you're taking pictures about other people. And lastly, I would say London is amazing, having so many beautiful, absolutely gorgeous cafes which are really Instagram worthy, and I'll mention just a couple of them, but there are so much more of them. So it's Peggy Portion, Elan Cafe, Dominic Ansel Bakery, and so much more. I can't even remember all of them in one go, but I'm sure if you take a look around central London, you will find at least one of the lovely flower decorated cafes. So that's all my most favorite spots. And I did not include anything which would be more like historical locations such as Tower Bridge and so on. I chose more modern or nature related areas in London which I love for Instagram, but obviously there are so much more to see. And I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give a thumbs up and please let me know in the comments below what are your most favorite spots in London or in your own city, which I would love to hear because I do love to travel and I would love to find those lovely places. And if you would like to see more of my videos, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and I will see you next Sunday. Bye.